What drives you on?
At this very moment, it's Montserrat Caballé.
She's the best. Now I'm going to opera, you know. Forget rock and roll.
He says, look, I have now heard the best voice in the world.
He was just like a 12-year-old kid seeing the Beatles.
He said, go and find her and tell her I want to sing with her.
He was a little shy in the beginning to sing with me.
He was so nervous that instead of saying, how lovely to meet you, would you like some lunch? He just blurted out, I've written a song for you, would you like to hear it?
She said, how many songs does a normal rock and roll album have? And I said, something like 10. Oh, we'll do 10 songs then.
And we knew we were away. And then she went on to say, but the song I really want is about my hometown. I want a song about Barcelona.
I had this perfect dream.
Sueño me volvió.
This dream was me and you.
I'm sure the opera critics would, you know, slam it and everything. But I mean, this is something that it's a good challenge at this time in life, you know.
Miracle sensation, my guiding inspiration.
Well, the first album had sold about 130,000 copies, and CBS were reeling from the loss that they made on the first album. So I approached Walter Yetnikoff in New York, and he sat there. He said, well, I understand, we've got to do a second album, so what is it? I said, well, it's a duet album. And he said, oh, well, that sounds interesting. That's you know, might get something of that. Duetting with who? And I said, it's Montserrat Caballé. She's a Spanish opera singer. And he completely freaked. And in the end, he paid us quite a substantial amount of money to go away and deliver the album somewhere else, which is what we did.
It was a difficult thing. Don't forget, this had never been done before, really.
And we delivered the album, and it was a huge success. Now that we're at the 25th anniversary of the Barcelona song, it seemed the right moment to do what I'm quite sure Freddie would have wanted, which was to do the album with full orchestra and not with keyboards. So we are working with Stuart Morley, who's our musical director from We Will Rock You in London, and he has gone back to the album and orchestrated it faithfully for full 80-piece orchestra. Then we will put Freddie and Montserrat's voice back onto that and realise the album that I think should have been there had he had the balls to do it at the time.
Every song that is inside the album is an encounter, two worlds encounter.
Rising sun will bless my morning with a smile, a magic puff from the sea.
And in the same time, two friends love it for music because he loves music so much.
I think one of the reasons that Freddie put so much of himself into the Barcelona project was the fact that he had just found out of his AIDS status.
Where can I be long? In this great big world of sadness, how can I forget?
In his mind, he had to create the best music he could for Barcelona because it might be the last thing that he was ever involved in.
Every time I saw it, I see his adieu.
He absolutely immersed himself into this album completely and utterly.
I'm glad I did it. It was a totally different adventure. I'd like to see other rock and roll singers try things like that, you know, and see if they can get away with it.
They probably couldn't get away with it, Freddie, but you did.
There you are. I'm wonderful, aren't I?
Yes, absolutely. I think this particular project will give the album a sort of second birth. Because a lot of people know the song, but they don't know that it comes from an album.
It was, for him, I think, possibly the most important work he ever did.